So Samsung did something unusual with the Galaxy A37, and trust me, this is not what anyone expected. Last year, they put a Snapdragon chip in the A36, this year they are going back to Exynos, but before you click away thinking it's a bad news, wait, because this time the story is completely different. So here is what happened. The Galaxy A36 came with the Snapdragon 6 Gen 3, a decent mid-range chip. Now everyone thought Samsung would keep using Snapdragon for the A37 too, but a fresh Geekbench leak shows the A37 is packing the Exynos 1480. Now, why did Samsung make this switch? Simple, money and strategy. Samsung has been spending billions buying Snapdragon chips from Qualcomm. By using their own Exynos processor, they save costs and reduce dependence on other companies. But here is the twist, they are not downgrading, they are actually upgrading. The Exynos 1480 isn't just any chip, it's the same processor that powered the Galaxy A55, a more expensive phone. And it comes with an AMD-powered GPU based on RDNA architecture, that's a gaming-focused graphic chip. Now let's talk numbers. The A37 scored around 1158 in single core and 3401 in multi-core on Geekbench. Now compare that to the A36, that's a 15% performance jump. The GPU is also about 29% faster, so you are getting better app performance, smoother multitasking and way better gaming. So what does this mean for you? If you are planning to buy a budget Samsung phone, the A37 is shaping up to be a serious upgrade. You are getting a chipset from a higher tier phone, which means it should handle daily tasks, gaming and heavy apps much better than A36 did. Look, Samsung switching chips might sound confusing, but this time they have made the right call. The Exynos 1480 is a proven performer, and bringing it to a more affordable phone is actually a smart move for buyers like us. We still don't know about the camera, battery or display specs yet, but if Samsung keeps the same formula and adds this performance boost, the A37 could be one of the best budget phone of 2025. So what do you think? Are you excited about the A37 or waiting for more details? Drop your thoughts below. With that being said, subscribe if you like, and I will see you in the next one.